time?
We got probably halfway up.
Coming up to the cliff?
Well, we went up that first draw, remember?
Yeah.
We got probably halfway up.
I don't think I have those pictures anymore.
I don't either.
You and I up on the cliffs? Yeah. I might, I don't know. I saved almost every trip we've had. They're all saved in my laptop.
How deep is the canyon? Where it goes away, there's a trail on the other side. If you were, I would have, you may have made it, but the trail would be kind of sketchy. There's a trail on the other side of the canyon. It goes up and you actually get to like a 30-foot waterfall. Yeah, and then there's a road that goes up the rest of it. Eventually, the road itself gets up on the ridge top. You can drive on. There's a whole bunch of 4x4 trails around out here. Mm-hmm. They're fun.
Well, look at the large pictures that we got.
Oh, dog.
Yeah. You can just swipe through them.
Dude,
they were so damn good.
I'm so dope. There's so many.
Yeah. We came around the corner of the trail and it was just all of a sudden larches everywhere.
I love you guys, babe. I don't think there's more beautiful mountain range.
It looks almost like someone man-made garden at some point.
Mm-hmm.
With all those rocks, the boulders that we saw. It looked like a rock garden.
I don't know, the Rocky Mountains around Glacier National Park are pretty damn good.
Those are pretty awesome. Yeah. Well, really? Is this what spilled?
No, none of it spilled. I just said I still have.
Oh, you still?
Yeah. I couldn't remember if I was out or not.
It's the same stuff?
Yeah, the cherry whiskey.
Yeah.
Oh, interesting.
I like that orange rock candy one you had.
Really?
Orange rock.
That was better. I like that one better than the other one.
Orange, it tastes like orange peel and plain rock candy. It's pretty good.
Interesting.
No, this is probably the first or second best cider I enjoy.
No, really?
This honey pear stuff, it's really good.
Just take them all.
Yeah, you may.
Bye. I'm going back to the car.
It's a bag of the keys, don't you?
So where was this hike? This was up near Ross Lake?
Yeah, this was up on
North
Washington Pass, Rainy Pass, up on Highway 20.
Oh, okay.
So this is actually the Pacific Crest Trail going north from Rainy Pass.
What, Maple Pass is
nearby
there?
Yeah, it's like 5 miles away. Five miles further down the road.
I've hiked around there.
Yeah.
God, that's so beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
I'm super jealous of that. That would be a sight to see.
It's like a once-in-a-lifetime type of hike.
There's one of those hikes where it's like you see, you have views the whole time. You know, it's not like a hike where like half the time it's like, okay, let's get through all these freaking trees. You know,
it's mostly like gorge and like dry hike. You hike through the viewpoint, and then it's like, you know, the mountains are this big.
Mm-hmm. But even like before the larches, we saw like the huckleberries.
Yeah.
Crossing like 5 foot streams and all that. You come up again, we'll do it again.
Oh, yeah.
At the right time.
That's
a hike worth doing like 5 times at least.
Yeah, that's a hike worth doing a bunch of times.
Someday.
Man, I was surprised you got sent up here twice in like, what, 3 months?
Yeah, I'm pretty stoked. Yeah, that was a good time on the last one. I ended up going to North Cascades and Trapper's Peak area.
Mm-hmm.
And I bagged a couple peaks over like 3 days. And this is pretty. There's no getting around. I got some views of the picket range. There you go. Yeah. And that, dude, God, that's a 20 sub.
Yeah, I wanted to do that hike, the Thornton Lake Trapper's Peak hike, but there's just so many hikes to do out here.
Dude, oh, I know.
It's
and there's
like
probably like 100 ones that are like just as nice that are closer, you know.
Mm, it's like there's so many options, you're almost overwhelmed at what you want to go do. Well, what do I want to go do this week? Do I want to go to the ocean? Do I want to go to the rainforest? Do I want to go to the desert? Do I want to go to the mountains?
So many options, so little time.
Yeah,
every landscape you have, like 3 hour difference.
Mm-hmm.
What now?
Every landscape is here.
Yeah, you can go do virtually anything you want. Any ecosystem you want to visit besides the tropics you've got in Washington. Fucking 3 hour drive from Seattle.
Forest side.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of forest side. It is unique looking. And it's beautiful in a lot of places.
Yeah.
It is.
Alright. know. I'd go visit swamps in like November when it's cool down, cool and crisp.
It's getting there, yeah. November's supposed to be when it starts getting cooler, but for most of this season, it's not that.
For most of the country, it didn't do that, including us. Till the very end, and it got really cold.
Yeah, it was like 70 degrees in like late November, 70 degrees one day, and 3 days later.
So yeah, the cold snap rolled through right during Thanksgiving, went from 75 to 25.
My dad was putting up the Christmas lights, and he's like, God, it's hot out there. I'm like, yeah, it's not supposed to be.
Yeah.
I know. I have to find a new hiking buddy if you die, and that's a pain in the ass to do.
It's too late for you.
Most of my little bitches, I don't want to go out when it's nice and sunny out.
There's no excuse when it's sunny.
That's what I'm saying. They only want to go out when it's sunny.
I'm fine with no rain. Other than that.
Unless you're on the ocean, then rain kind of.
Rain's kind of fun.
That's kind of the whole point of going out.
Like rain on the beach is kind of fun. Yeah. Otherwise, I'll stay home.
I know, we're weird. We like going out to the ocean beaches when it's rainy and stormy and 30 mile an hour winds because the waves get pretty big.
Oh, that would be cool to see.
It's sick. That's my favorite time to be out at the ocean when it's stormy.
It's kind of like
on the beach when it's nice and sunny is cool and all, but everybody else is out there, man.
Yeah.
When you have to lean into the wind the whole time you're walking is when it's nice.
It's like, no, hair in the chest there.
It's kind of like that when we went to Hilo on that one day.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that one day. That one day we had in Hilo was
waves just crashing onto the street.
Yeah. I'll take that over the Kona side though.
Yeah.
That sucked.
Yeah. Kona was kind of
hot and dreary.
Yeah. Many people. Use up our deep sea fishing. That was kind of fun.
Yeah. To restock my snacks for the first time in like 3 months.
Oh, yeah.
I've been going on hikes. All right, time to stop for a snack. Damn it. Oh, shit.
Yeah. I was thinking. I left it in the car.
You want a granola bar?
A little further up. Oh, I think it's from you.
It's a Costco shopping trip away.
Oh.
So we got everything. I mean, we got Starbucks. We got Costco. We got all the good.
No,
they might be a little hard.
Just keep throwing
that's too
shit.
Much, bro.
They might be a little hard.
No.
I've got like 5 of them.
Oh, he's about to be warm. Oh,
I'm prepared, Ethan. I don't come out here half-assed.
Nope.
Yeah.
Everyone's asking in the chat, where are you in Ellensburg? So I said, cuz.
Brandon had a friend from Georgia up here in Tri-Cities, and they had to go play in the snow in the desert.
Snow in the desert. They'll be like, wait, what?
Yeah.
Hypo?
I appreciate y'all driving all the way out here.
Yeah.
Come meet me. And being flexible with the plan. I was driving on the road in that fog. I was like, man, it's going to take me all day to get to the place.
We're just thinking fresh meat.
Yeah. That girl fights.
One of us. It'd be nice to have a third party a lot, but
yeah,
our friends don't like hiking. So.
Dog, if I was out here.
I mean, most of our friends do. They're just not.
Well, I mean, they're too busy and or live too far away.
And are inexperienced, like Alexei.
Yeah, that's so, you know, small people that are going to be huffing and puffing.
They like the idea of it, but Josh and I have done so much stuff, we don't want to do any easy stuff anymore. So we go do hard stuff, and they're like, this is stupid. This is scary. It's like, yeah, I know. I should have called it back for you.
I don't mind doing easy stuff if we had to bring someone along.
Mm-hmm.
Like, sometimes, yeah, do I want to strain myself to find a good view or to get to an alpine lake? Yeah, sure.
Mm-hmm.
But some days I'm just like, you know what, let's just take an easy elevation, just walk around. I'm kind of a mix. That's the part of me he doesn't like.
I'm fine with easy. I just easy hikes have their time and place. When you can't get to the hard stuff, you do the easy stuff in the winter.
Plus, he's been hiking since he was born, so. I started late in college when he started tagging me along.
I was his experimentation.
I guess I pass with a B.
Exactly. This time of year, yeah, there's a bunch of riverside trail hikes we could go do down low. We could cover 15 miles in a day and you get rained on the whole time, but you're not going to have to worry about snow or anything. Yeah. You can still put the miles down and get the views, and you're going to be looking at a river. You're not getting up in the mountains, but it's still pretty good for the
wind. I want more coastal hikes from the Civic.
It's a lot of driving. I'm willing to put the miles on your car.
Yeah.
That means we'd be
getting... Well, we would take my car.
But we'd still be having to leave my apartment at like 4 a.m.
Yeah.
But a long way out there.
Yeah, it's like...
Go out to the push or something.
I mean...
Too far.
Yeah.
We can go do that now, but that's what we're going to go do in March, too.
Where we're going for the south of La Push, right?
No. Nope. Well, at least one of the days we're going to be in La Push. Well, if you want to go do that sooner, we can go do that sooner. You're just going to have to show up, and we're going to have to leave at like 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock in the morning to get out there by daylight.
Yeah.
It's a lot of driving, but I'm down.
Maybe something Sabrina would want to do, too.
Hmm?
Maybe something Sabrina would want to do.
Oh, I should actually be out there. I'm surprised at how well the two of you liked skiing when I took you out to skiing.
I mean, I like snowboarding more. But so long as it's skiing with a grouped trail.
That's a lot of money to snowboard.
Yeah, no, it's like, I want to go up to Stevens Pass.
Talking cross-country
like,
skiing.
Yeah.
I want to go up to Stevens Pass at least once, but it's like freaking...
$600.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then it's like, you wait in line for 20 minutes.
Whereas you go buy a set of cross country skis off Craigslist for $20, go buy another set of boots for another $20, go buy the snow park permit for like $100 for the season, you can go wherever the fuck they plow.
Yeah, those intermediate.
Sure, it's flat most of the time, and it takes a while to get up to the views, but you're not waiting in line with nobody. And the worst you gotta deal with is a couple of snowmobiles every once in a while.
That'd be fun,
too. That's what I'd love to do. His uncle owns a couple of snowmobiles, they haven't touched them like a decade. I'd love to get those running.
No, he's touched them.
Huh?
He's touched them. He just doesn't plan shit.
Are they running?
Yeah. My dad did it in like 2019. So, I know. I need to ask him.
There's like 1,000 miles of plowed snowmobile trails in this state.
Yeah, you guys.
I know. Him and my dad went up to Wenatchee.
Yeah.
But,
Rex can pull two snowmobiles. Especially
those
two little ones.
I
want to
ask him,
has.
Like, when he comes over for Christmas, I'm going to ask him. And he'll be like, yeah, totally. And then he won't plan it.
I mean, I think we're old enough and responsible enough now, we could probably take it just the two of us. We won't go do anything crazy, but just like, you know, take it out Salmon the Sack, go up to Cooper River, go up Cooper Lake or something.
Yeah.
Something easy where we can't get lost, where we know the scenery, know the road, just, you know, check out the snowmobiles, see how they roll.
That'd be badass.
See how they function.
Always thought that'd be a lot of fun.
I'm totally down for that.
Yeah.
I'll buy gas and everything, I don't give a fuck.
I'll ask him to see if we can do it this winter.
Whole realm of snow sports I've never really been done.
Even out here, like, we have the opportunity, but it's just so damn expensive to do that.
And far. I mean, resort skiing is pretty brutal no matter where you go. It's cheap in North Carolina, but you get like two runs. And they have like, I think the biggest slope in North Carolina has like 600 feet of vertical relief. So so there are big mountains. There's fairly big mountains in North Carolina. Like, there's some mountains that have 3,500 feet of vertical relief. Mm-hmm. When you come from the Smokies to Gatlinburg, you got a vertical mile between. You know, so there is some big stuff, but none of the ski resorts.
It's just so expensive to start up and do that stuff.
I know, and they're all broke down as hell. Like, it's some ratty looking places, but.
No, fuck. The cross-country ski tour Nash and I did up to Moich Lake, I think we covered 1,500 feet over 5 miles.
That sucked.
Well,
the foggy view at the end was okay, but the trip there sucked. I do not want to do that again.
Well, we'll do it again, but when we have the bright...
You'll do it again. I ain't doing that again.
Let me finish my damn sentence for you. We were on track skis for backcountry ski. When I purchase the correct width of skis, it'll be... third of the work, if that.
Oh, you had some wide skis on?
Mm-hmm. We had little skinny track skis, and we were breaking trail. Mm-hmm. So we were pretty much snowshoeing in our skis for 5 miles.
Bullshit. Ski touring, like, backcountry, that seems That would be fun to do.
Especially going up like a road, like a road that's not plowed for the winter. Most of these thousands of miles of logging roads you can go up in the winter here. Just buy a set of like 80 millimeter wide skis instead of the 40 millimeter you use in the track. And they're good. I've done my proper research. I know what I need to get now, so we don't have that mistake again. Yeah, no, that was not. It was a good learning experience.
Yeah, I imagine it's a pretty steep learning curve for most of the snow winter stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I was pretty surprised how quickly I picked up skiing and snowboarding. I did a lot of skateboarding when I was little, so I had the balance thing handled. So my brother took me up snowboarding for the first time in like 2016. And he's been doing it since middle school. And so he takes me up and, all right, here we go. And he goes down. He's like, you'll be fine. Don't worry. And I go, I know.
I know.
There's some transfer for skateboarding.
Yeah.
I almost feel like, you remember the rip sticks?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's
mm-hmm.
like a little bit more like snowboarding than.
Yeah, I really.
Mm-hmm. And there's it transfers a little bit, but not a huge amount.
I'll pick up skateboarding again as soon as I move out and there's a skate park nearby, because I'm not going to drive to a skate park. Like, I'm going to pay for gas for that.
Well, there's some good ones around Washington.
There are.
A lot of them might kind of tucked away.
Yeah. Where every town's like got a skate park.
Yeah, every town's got a couple of city parks, and at least two of the parks have skate parks built into them.
That's pretty dope.
I was surprised at how well Sabrina picked up skiing and how much she enjoyed it. That was a pleasant surprise for me.
The first try was.
When we went up to Blue Pass with Liv, that was hilarious.
That was hilarious. Liv was having so much fun falling, and Sabrina was just stressing the fuck out. Well,
no, she had a good time because Liv was there. If it had just been the three of us, she would not have had a good time. But yeah, no. My fiance likes to get out and do stuff, but our schedules don't line up well for having days off together and going and doing stuff, so it's hard.
Is when you can't get out, makes it better.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Which one of you has my damn class?
Right there.
Look at all that blue sky.
I don't see that.
You said they're going, pussies, why don't you continue? Cross the damn creek. Well, Nash, shall we say screw it and go have you scrotum for lunch?
Yeah.
You say you scrotum?
That's what we call the burger joint. It's really
good.
So
the burger joint's called You Totem.
Okay.
And so, my mom's friend who went to Central, she called it You Scrotum.
Back in like the 90s.
So I said that to my friends, and now it's picked up on them.
Oh. Yeah, that's...
So whenever we say it, we don't care who's near us, we'll say, you want to go to your scrotum? We get heads turning. Like, what the fuck are you saying? You're doing what to who's scrotum?
Despite the bad name we give it, it's fucking really good. We've probably ate there, probably 100 times too many in college. It's so good that we'd get our out-of-town friends would be willing to walk with us all the way across campus in snowstorms just to go get those.
Yeah, in the dead of winter.
In the dead
of winter at like 5 p.m.
And like... single digits, wind chill, they'd be like, all right, we're going to walk to you home. Yeah, because I ain't driving your fucking car in this weather, homie. Shitty
and then
out.
They don't dress properly for it. We're, like, Scott and I are decked in this, and they're all in their just sweatpants and, like, a t-shirt, and they're like, what?
The San Diego boy had to go on a little bit of a shopping spree when we went home for Christmas that first time.
Oh, because
he came back from Thanksgiving break for finals week and stuff, and the temperature had dropped, and he's like, oh shit, I'm like, yeah, you need this coat, homie, you need this pants, homie.
He was
wearing like half my fucking wardrobe.
Was that Riley?
Huh?
Was that Riley or
Jacob? Riley was okay.
Yeah.
Riley wears big
coats. He has no temperature.
Anyway.
Huh? He has no temperature. He can wear a t-shirt in 0 degree weather,
he'll be fine. He'll be fine. Just give him his ice Starbucks and he's good to go. Oh yeah, that sun's coming out good on the hill over there. Working out. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'd like to not drive home in the fog. That would
be nice. That would be nice,
yeah.
I mean, you have to get me home alive. You have to get me back to North Bend alive, so my mom will kill you.
Have we ever crashed before? No.
We almost did.
Have we come close a couple of times? We don't need to say that.
No, it was only that one time where we were, it was in October, it was snowing.
Oh, where we almost ran into the Tacoma up at Cooper River? Yeah.
We hit that guy where I thought he was going to fall off the cliff.
Oh, Subaru.
Yeah, him.
Oh, the guy him. Yeah.
Track pants.
Some dorky little high school kid was driving up in his mom's Subaru. Going up a Forest Service road in weather worse than this, and I was coming down. We've just been on a whole day of snow wheeling, having a great time. You know, my vehicle's built for it, so whatever. We're coming down nice and slow, and this kid's just blasting up this hillside. We come around this blind corner, and we touch bumpers.
Oh.
We get out, and it's like, I've got a steel bumper. Nothing's gonna happen to me. Yeah. I get like, oh shit, I'm gonna have to get a ticket and all this shit for it. We look at his bumper, no damage. Kind of look at him, and go, this didn't happen. Yup.
Bobby doesn't have to know.
But exactly. He was moving backwards when we hit him. We thought he was gonna fall off the cliff.
Yeah, he saw us and slammed on his brakes and started going reverse, and he couldn't stop going in reverse.
No.
I thought he was gonna go over. It was like a 300-foot cliff on the other side. I was like, oh God, please.
We're gonna witness a death today.
Uh-huh. Some kid's gonna die on my watch because he's an idiot. Great.
Somebody that ate it about as good as it possibly could.
Yeah, exactly.
But yeah, there was that, and then there was when we were at Kavanaugh.
Oh yeah, we're almost drifted off the curb. Yeah, that would have been,
we almost fell on the side.
Oh. You know, I was being a dumbass fishtailing around, and I almost lost it and went over the cliff. It was in the middle of the summer on a gravel road, so there was no excuses.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh.
I'm just being like, look at this, and then went and didn't come back. Oh God, it's not coming back. Oh God. And to make it worse, there was a car coming up the hill, and it's just watching me, bro.
All doing the truck.
Hey, bro. Yeah, they're just
judging the hell out of us. You damn teenagers.
They saved it with about 6 inches to spare and got back in. So then I didn't even look at the guy going by, just nope.
You don't see nothing. It's one of those situations where you're laughing, but you're shitting your pants.
Yeah, you're laughing because you didn't die.
That's
what it is.
Yeah. You're laughing because nothing bad happened. Please. We survived with no damage. Yay!
Won't do that again.
Maybe.
Not till next season.
No. We've only had, one close call while hiking so far?
You almost fell off.
That's what I was talking about.
Cooper River? Yeah.
There's a ravine.
Yeah, when we go waterfall hunting.
That steep. We're waterfall hunting.
Probably about
what? Waterfall hunting.
Oh, we find waterfalls and
this is slope
that looks like that, but it's dirt instead of rock.
It's about 9,500 feet tall. We went down to the bottom of the waterfall, hung out. It's a really pretty waterfall.
Yeah, we didn't expect it to be there.
Yeah, this waterfall's a lot bigger than what I thought we were gonna find. It was fucking sweet. So we're coming back up, snaking our way back up, crisscrossing back up. And we're going along, we're 20 feet back from the top. And I hear Nash go, and I see him, and he's on 1 foot leaning in the wrong direction.
it's
like 80 feet straight back down with one little tree to catch him. God.
We took the same path going up. It was the same route that we grabbed onto going down.
Oh.
So I thought, okay, it's sturdy enough.
Grabs the root, it just comes out.
Just comes out. And so I go, say, Scotty, I almost died.
That feeling right there, you feel that in your stomach.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh.
Your stomach drops into your nuts, and your nuts go up into your throat.
Yeah, that would have been a dirty long way.
Yeah, I think that's the
closest. That was the only close call we've had so far.
Yeah, that's the closest call we've had. All the dumb shit we've done.
And he's taking me on, I think this is, if you're counting this as a hike, this has got to be, number 80.